Okay, I got the little witch's hat because she talks about the fortune teller. I got little, moon phase earrings, for the fortune teller again. Really focusing in on the fortune teller, and I have a little story about that too. But anyway, here's Torn by Natalie imbruglia. Thank you for watching. Crappy Valentine's Day. Mary Skelly says hi and bye. Ow, my knee hurts. Okay. Okay, I guess I just. Oops. I guess I'll just put my knee back up. I guess I want to talk about the fortune teller part a little bit because I did. My roommate invited her friend over who does tarot readings, and my roommate was like, "You should do a tarot reading for this guy." And this was in December when we just moved into a new place. And the guy was about to go to his mom's for Christmas. And anyway, so there was a tarot reader. She came over. Actually, he had already left. So, like, he came over the night that we moved in, and then he left for Christmas the next day. So, yeah. Anyway, a tarot reader came over later, and my roommate was like, "You should ask about him." And in my mind, before she said that, I was like, "I'm asking it about," like, I had someone else in mind that I was like thinking of. And so I was like, "I'm gonna think about this person." And so they're telling me all this stuff, and like one of the things I remember was like, she's like, "He's thinking about the world and you're thinking about him." And I was like, "Well, I'm actually not thinking about him right now for like this reading because I'm thinking about someone else." So I'm like, "That's fine." And another thing that I remember her saying was like, "You seem like a Greek god." And I was like, "I don't think I do." So like I really wasn't thinking about him for that reading, but I like let my roommate think that I was. Anyway, then later I was making like one of the, I said I make memes. I would send some to the group chat for work, but like I would send this person like memes of them individually. So it was like, why did I bring that up? Right, because the day before Valentine's Day, aka the day that this person and their partner are now, that's like their anniversary. Anyway, the day before Valentine's Day, I sent a Valentine's meme to them of like cut out on, there's like a statue of like Saint Valentine. They like look all ripped and stuff. I was like, "Happy Valentine's Day Eve." And then I thought of that like tarot reading and I was like, "You see him as a Greek god." I'm like, I'm literally like photoshopping his face onto the statue, the Greek god right now. So I'm like, I guess I can kind of see how that would really but like whatever, that was so long ago. And then the next day, and I'm not a tarot person, but I like astrology, and I was looking at our synastry and our birth charts, and there were like some good things, like our moons are pretty close to a trine, and then like I had his wrong birth time, and so when I updated it, our moons were even closer to a trine than they were when I originally looked at it. But then, little did I know, I had my own birth time wrong. So, when I update that, then our moons are like further apart. So, it was all a lie. Anyway, but his Jupiter is like conjunct my sun, and I thought that was like cool. But then it's in his 11th house, and I'm like, that's like the house of friends, not like relationships. And the sun is the ruler of my 7th house. But I was like, for him, this is like I don't think he's gonna see me as more than like a friend or like even a coworker, maybe. But yeah, like I said, someone, my roommate, convinced me that he was like, she's like, "He asks about you all the time, blah blah blah." And I'm like, okay, like let's see. Like, you gotta trust your intuition, ladies, and I guess anyone else who has intuition. I don't want to gender it anyway. Yeah, trust your intuition. That's all I want to say. Okay, bye. Squeak, squeak.